Collision theory on reaction rate. As you have got how to express the rate of a chemical reaction, R is equal minus dA by dt, like that you can express the rate of chemical reaction. By applying differential rate law also you can express the rate of chemical reaction. Similarly, this is one of the theory which is called collision theory. By applying this collision theory also you can express the rate of a chemical reaction. Now I'll tell you what is collision theory. According to collision theory, a reaction takes place because the reactant molecules collide with each other. According to collision theory, a reaction takes place because the reactant molecules collide with each other. For example, suppose this is a reaction A plus B, it gives the product P. When the reaction takes place, number of collisions takes place between this A molecule and B molecule. I mean, between the reactant molecule, number of collisions takes place, and due to this collision, the reactant will break and the product will form. So a reaction will take place only because of the reactant molecules are collide with each other. And in paragraph you can write, the number of collisions taking place per unit volume in a reaction mixer is called collision frequency, and this collision frequency is represented by a symbol Z. So the number of collisions taking place per unit time per unit volume in a reaction mixer, it is called collision frequency. So when you carry out a reaction, the number of collisions takes place between the reactant molecules, and how many collisions taking place in 1 second, I mean per unit time, how many collisions taking place in 1 second, that is called collision frequency, and which is represented by the symbol Z. If Z is the collision frequency and f is the fraction of molecules whose collisions are effective. If Z is the collision frequency and F is the fraction of molecules whose collisions are effective, then the rate of reaction R is equal, you can write Z into F. I mean, when you multiply collision frequency with the fraction of molecules whose collisions are effective, when you multiply this, then you will get the rate of a chemical reaction. So by applying this collision theory, you can express the rate of reaction like this. To write the rate of reaction, it requires two things. One is collision frequency and one is fraction of molecules whose collisions are effective. I'll tell you what is fraction of molecules whose collisions are effective. So when you multiply Z with F, you will get the rate of chemical reaction. Now I'll tell you what is F. The fraction of molecules whose collisions are effective is related with temperature. Is related with temperature. The relation is F is equal e to the power minus Ea by RT. F you can determine by using this relation also. F is equal, this is exponential. Ea is called activation energy. You will get later what is activation energy. R means the gas constant, universal gas constant, PV is equal nRT equation, gas constant, and T is the temperature. So F you can determine like this way, how many fractions of molecules whose collisions are effective, you can find out e to the power minus Ea by RT equation. So when you put this equation, I mean when you put this value of F in this equation, then you can write R is equal Z into e to the power minus Ea by RT. So by using this equation, you can determine the rate of a chemical reaction by applying this collision theory. Now I'll tell you what is this F. As you know, Z is collision frequency. Collision frequency means nothing, how much collisions taking place in 1 second. That is called collision frequency. I'll tell you F, what is F. Actually, what is F? For example, this is one reaction, NO2 plus NO2, it gives N2O4. Suppose this is a chemical reaction. Here, who is the reactant? NO2 is the reactant. So, who undergo collision? This NO2 collide with this NO2. So, collision takes place between NO2 molecule. Now, suppose this is one NO2 molecule, NO2. This is one NO2 molecule. When they undergo collision, they collide like this. Collision takes place like this. And this is one NO2. And this is one NO2. When the collision takes place, they collide like this. Let's see this collision and this collision. Here collision is taking place between nitrogen and nitrogen. Here collision is taking place between nitrogen and oxygen. According to collision theory, this type of collision, which are in a proper direction or which are in proper orientation, this type of collisions are called effective collision. This type of collisions are not said to be the effective collision. And one thing you should know, when a reaction takes place, when the reactant undergo collision, during this collision, they provide some amount of energy. And that energy helps in the reaction. But only this type of collision, which are in proper direction, this type of collision provides the energy. This type of collision do not provide the energy. And that's why this type of collisions are not called effective collision. So when you carry out a reaction in a reaction vessel, number of collisions taking place between the reactant molecules. So when these collisions are taking place, some collisions are effective and some collisions are non-effective like this. This type of non-effective collision do not provide energy for the reaction. That is why all the collisions taking place inside the reaction vessel, all the collisions are not said to be the effective collision. Only this type of collisions are said to be effective. So F, what was F? F is the fraction of molecules whose collisions are effective. I mean, it is the number of molecules whose collisions are effective collision. And Z means what? Z means number of collisions, total number of collisions, both effective and non-effective per second. In 1 second, how many collisions takes place? That is represented by Z. And F means it is the fraction of molecules whose collisions are effective one. So this type of collision provides the energy for the chemical reaction. And that is called F. I mean fraction of molecules whose collisions are effective. So when you carry out a reaction inside the reaction vessel, number of collisions takes place, but all the collisions are not said to be the effective collision. Those collisions which are effective, they are represented by F. And all the collisions, whether they are effective or non-effective, they are represented by your Z symbol. Z means number of collisions taking place per unit volume per unit time. Thank you.